What's up guys? Today's video is on the top 5 best low profile mechanical keyboards. So I made the list from personal opinion, in hours of research, and I've included different options for every type of buyer. As always, all links to the product mentioned in the video will be in the description box, down below. Like the video, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. So, here are the top 5 best low profile mechanical keyboards. The fifth product on our list is the Havit HV-KB395L Ultra Thin Mechanical Keyboard. This is our pick for the best budget low-profile mechanical keyboard. It is available for around $70. It measures 0.89 inches of thickness, which is more than 25% thinner than a standard 104-key keyboard, and weighs as little as 1.2 pounds. Even with its very low height, an experienced user can easily tell that the Havit KB395L is a mechanical keyboard. It is a very minimalistic design, with plain surfaces and clean, rounded edges. Only a polished chrome trim along the edge of the keyboard slightly stands out. It is a standard 104 keys keyboard that fully adheres to the ANSI layout. The bottom row of the keyboard has a 6.25x spacebar, and 7.1.25x bottom row keys. The only difference here is that Havit replaced the right Win key with an FN key that is used to access the keyboard's advanced features. The keycaps are made from ABS plastic and have normal-sized characters printed on them. Both the primary and the secondary character is printed at the top of each keycap, allowing both of the characters to be visible once the LED lighting is on. The secondary characters are positioned peculiarly as if they are superscripts of the primary character, which may be confusing for a few people. The keys are individually lit with RGB backlighting and caps, scroll, and number lock functionality is clearly illuminated. On the bottom, we have 2 feet and general model information, which keeps everything simple. The micro USB port can be found on the rear towards the center. This can aid in keeping the cable away from any mouse pads in the immediate vicinity. Some of the pros for this product include: great typing experience, mechanical keys, super slim profile, detachable cable. However, a con for this product: the thin design causes flex in the middle. One feature we would have liked to see implemented on the bottom of the HV-KB395L is a third leg in the center of the keyboard. As the keyboard is so thin, we did notice a bit of bowing when typing and gaming, and a little bit of extra support in the center would really help solidify things. In fourth place, we have the Cooler Master SK650. Our pick for the best design low-profile mechanical keyboard. Available for $90, this keyboard is not only light enough to fit in a narrow laptop bag, but it is also super thin thanks to their Chariot Max low-profile red switches and flat, chiclet-style keys. This low-profile aesthetic is certainly attractive. The RGB lighting and aluminum base look great. But it leads to a unique key feel that not everyone will like. The keyboard comes with braided, 1.8-meter USB Type-C to Type-A cables that are removable. This also comes with a black drawstring bag you can put it in for safe travel. The build quality of the SK650 is decent. It features a brushed aluminum top plate, akin to Cooler Master's flagship MK750 gaming keyboard. A reflective bezel offers a nice accent along the outer edge. It features a braided cable that's detachable, so you won't need to replace the whole board in the event of a broken wire, and it's USB Type-C as well. The SK650 is lightweight at 1.47 pounds, which is great for traveling though does allow for some flex when pressed on. The keys are quiet, though. If you've ever used a mechanical keyboard, or even sat next to someone using one, you know how noisy they can be. A side benefit of the low-profile design is that it has a muting effect on noise when bottoming out. Some of the pros of this product include: light, thin, and easy to carry. Detachable, USB Type-C cable. Gorgeous lighting effects. Attractive, flat shape. However, a con for this product: polarizing low-profile switches. The SK650 is a gorgeous keyboard. The minimalist aesthetic works well with a low-profile design. The brushed aluminum and several exposed screws also give it a slightly industrial look that I really like. Like most RGB keyboards, the SK650 uses a floating key design which allows you to see illuminated switch housings underneath the keys. The RGB is bright and vibrant, and the reflection on the aluminum top plate enhances the shine in a really appealing way. The lights can all be turned off if you're not a fan of RGB or sleep in the same room as your keyboard. The third product on our list is Logitech G915 Wireless Mechanical Gaming Keyboard. It is available at around $230. This is our pick for the best wireless low-profile mechanical keyboard. The keyboard itself is nice and compact with dimensions of around 0.8 inches height, 18.7 inches width, 5.8 inches depth, and it weighs 2.3 pounds. The Logitech G915 is rather large, as it's a full-size keyboard and has an added column of dedicated macro keys. The Logitech G915 is a superb low-profile wireless mechanical gaming keyboard. It's a full-size keyboard that's packed with features such as dedicated macro keys, multi-device pairing, and full RGB backlighting. Logitech's G-Hub software offers a host of customization options and is easy to use, however, it's only available for Windows and Mac OS. The keyboard's low profile is comfortable to type on and it comes in three variants: tactile, similar to Cherry MX Brown, clicky, blue, and linear red. We tested the tactile model, but we expect most of our results to apply to the other variants, except for typing experience. The G915 runs on the Logitech G-Hub software, which is pretty good as these programs go. You can program a variety of different color effects, from per key lighting to reactive rainbows that ripple across the keyboard when you type. Build quality is great. It has a metal frame and hard plastic on the back. The keyboard exhibits some flex due to the thinness of the board, but it's fairly minimal. Although the keycaps are double shot, which is great for the durability of the key legends, they're made of ABS plastic, which can pick up oil easily and develop a shine over time. Some of the pros for this product include: discrete media keys, robust software, beautiful design, excellent key switches. However, a con for this product: no wrist rest. The G915's biggest feather in its cap is wireless connectivity. You can connect the device via a USB dongle, which works flawlessly, or Bluetooth, which also works flawlessly, depending on how well your devices handle Bluetooth connections. The second product on our list is Cooler Master SK621. This is our pick for the best 60% and wireless, low-profile mechanical keyboard. It is priced at around $90. 60% keyboards remove the F row and arrow keys home cluster as well as the numpad, creating an even more compact keyboard that takes up very little desk space. Measuring 11.5 by 4 by 1.1 inches and weighing about a pound, the SK621 is small and light enough to carry comfortably in a laptop bag or backpack. The SK621 can be used either wirelessly via Bluetooth, you can save pairings for up to 3 devices, or wired via USB-C. Cooler Master includes a nearly 6-foot-long braided cable. Many of the dedicated functions such as home and page up-down, as well as multimedia playback controls, have been added to alphanumeric keys. Cooler Master has devoted a lot of attention to aesthetics. The keyboard features a brushed aluminum top plate, floating keycaps, RGB backlighting, and gold trim around the chassis. The attention to detail extends to the accessories, as well: a braided USB Type-C cable for battery charging and wired connectivity, and a velvet tote sleeve. The keys themselves feel great, with decent travel, a satisfying click at the bottom of the stroke, and a springy rebound. They provide the tactile and audio feedback mechanical keyboard lover's prize. You can apply presets to modify the keyboard's per key backlighting. These range from static colors to dynamic effects that are activated by music or gaming actions. Some of the pros for this product include: tiny and attractive, wired or wireless via Bluetooth operation, more travel friendly than most other mechanicals, build quality feels solid. However, a con for this product: no dedicated function row. The SK621 is the tiniest and compact keyboard you'll have ever worked with or gamed on. However, it has all the essentials you need, from wireless to quality low-profile Cherry MX switches, and even an RGB setup that is bound to impress many. The software suite is properly functional but could be better though. And coming in the first place, we have the CORSAIR K70. This is our pick for the best overall low-profile mechanical keyboard. At this time, it is priced at around $130. The CORSAIR K70 RGB was a nearly perfect keyboard, featuring a sleek design, authentic Cherry MX switches, and a colorful array of rainbow backlights. The K70 RGB MK.2 is almost identical to the less expensive CORSAIR STRAFE RGB MK.2. Like the STRAFE, the K70 is a full-size keyboard, about 17 by 6 inches without the wrist rest, or 17 by 9 with it. There's very little wasted space on the attractive black chassis, and it's actually about an inch smaller than many comparable peripherals, while still maintaining comfortable spacing between the keys. What makes the K70 one of the very best keyboards, is that you can choose from 5 different Cherry switches: speed, red, brown, silent, and the underappreciated blues. The K70 RGB MK.2 runs on the CORSAIR Utility Engine software, which I've both praised for its extensive feature set and criticized for its opacity. The K70 Lux boasts several features intended to appeal to the gamer market. For example, it features 100% anti-ghosting, which is basically marketing speak for N-key rollover. There's a Windows lock button, as well as a switch at the back that allows you to set the report delay to 1, 2, 4, or 8 milliseconds, which can increase the polling rate to up to 1000 Hz. Some believe that high polling rates give you an edge in gaming, but you're still limited by the USB interface and the debouncing time, generally 5 milliseconds. Some of the pros for this product include: gorgeous design, key switch selection, high quality components, helpful extra features. However, a con for this product: it, in our opinion, is a bit expensive. It's one of the most expensive gaming keyboards on the market, and that's admittedly going to be a deal breaker for some buyers. But with a durable chassis and high quality mechanical switches, this keyboard is an investment that could keep you gaming for many years.